Okay. So, photo for today. So that's it. So there's the settings. 1/6 and f4.5. It's ISO 100. So I'm using this window. There's two parts of the window. There's this part and this part. And then it's blocked by this in the middle. So what this is doing is creating this little bit of gray on the wall behind me. But then the front, that's the back part, the window. And then the front of my face, this side, is getting filled in by this window. So 1/6 and 4.5, that's exposed for the window light. So if it was just the window light without that strobe, it'd be properly exposed. But then I add in this strobe, which is at 1/32nd power, if you can see that. It's 1/32nd. 24 millizoom, so pretty wide. That is what is blowing out all of this and getting that really, really high key effect. It's also lighting up my eyes a lot, but you know, the pupils are still black because it's a fairly directional light from the side. I was standing right there, so that's almost parallel with the light and perpendicular to the camera. So the window light is softening up all these shadows, but then you're adding in another exposure from the strobe. So essentially what you're doing is you're overexposing me twice. So you're exposing me twice. But since it's the strobe, it'll freeze everything and keep it nice and sharp. But you're still getting all double that light. So it'd be the same as if I had a big, huge, giant strip light here that was a strobe. Except this way, you just use a window, and it creates this really, really nice, soft light. You can see a little bit of shadow there. The strobe's mostly hitting in the back and the sides, so that's shadowed by my cheek. This side right here, you can see it's almost blown out. If we look at the histogram here, there's no blacks at all, but look at that white. There's so much overexposure. But, you know, that's okay. Sometimes that's just how it works. So that's that. I don't know. Let's see what else. Oh, yeah. So we got a remote trigger here. Got the transceiver for the strobe. Then we have the trigger for the strobe. There we go, now focus. So that's for the remote trigger. I just held that half press to focus. I had to put my focus, I wonder if you can see this. Yeah, you can see that little black dot. So I can move that around. So I had it on this one right here. I think it was this one. And this is where mostly where my eye was going to be and my cheek. So I wanted to have it focused on my cheek. If I had it focused, see, where's my finger? Up here. Then it would be on my hair, over here over my hair, or on my nose, or on my chin. But right here, it focuses on my eye. And that's what's really important in photography. Portrait photography is being focused on the eye. The eye is really where people are drawn to most. It's what you look at first, because you can tell so much from the eye. You know, you can tell if someone's angry, if they're mad, sad, blah, blah, blah. Any of the emotions, it all comes from the face and the eyes a lot. So having it in focus is really critical for traditional photography. Obviously, if you start messing with out of focus eyes or having one eye in focus, there was one in here, I think it was this one, where you can see this eye is in focus and this eye is not. It's kind of untraditional. Where the back eye is, but the front eye isn't. Or how it changes if I'm looking away from the camera. Blah, blah, blah. Facial posturing. The scale. See what difference that makes. And I think that's it. That's about it. See you tomorrow.